Let us focus now our hearts and minds on what
beautiful face to hide the pain. A beautiful face to hide the the wind beneath my wings.
It signifies the mysterious union between Christ and the church. And the Bible commends it to be honorable among all men. The union of husband and wife in heart, mind, and body is intended by God for their mutual joy and comfort, prosperity, and in times of adversity. And when our Lord so ordains for the procreation of children and that they nurture them in the admonition of the Lord. Therefore, marriage should not be entered into lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently and deliberately, according to the purpose in which it was instituted by God. Into this union now comes Joan Estelle Johnson and Thomas Levette Garcia. Joan and Thomas, I require both of you in the presence of God, if you know of any reason why you should not be lawfully married, do confess now.
Lizette.
Thomas Lizette Garcia, will thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her for long as ye both shall live?
I do.
Joan Estelle Johnson, would I have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Wilt thou obey him, serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live?
I do.
Who giveth this woman to be married to this man? Thomas Lizette Garcia.
I, Thomas Lizette Garcia.
Take thee, Joan Estelle Johnson.
Take thee, Joan Estelle Johnson.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Till death.
To death.
Us do part.
Us do part.
According.
According.
To God's holy ordinance.
To God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I plight thee. My troth. I, Joan Estelle Johnson.
I, Joan Estelle Johnson.
Take thee, Thomas Lizette Garcia.
Take thee, Thomas Lizette Garcia.
To be my husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
Cherish.
Cherish.
And to obey.
And
death.
To death.
Us do part.
Us do part.
According.
According.
To God's holy ordinance.
To God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I give thee.
I give thee.
My troth.
My troth.
Joan, what one word describes your duty in this marriage?
To submit.
Thomas, what one word describes your duty in this marriage?
Sacrifice.
Do we have rings? These rings are a sign and a symbol of the never-ending love that you promised to share with each other. May I remind both of you that your love can only endure as you grow together in God's grace. As a pledge.
As a pledge.
And in token.
And in token.
Of the vows.
And the vows.
Between us made.
Between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Pledge.
As a pledge.
And in token.
And in token.
Of the vows.
Of the vows.
Between us made.
Between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
This time we want to focus our attention to the unity candle due to God's ordained will. It has been his sovereign decision to allow the wind to blow so appropriately, which has made it difficult for the center candle on the calabra to be lit. One of the gifts of being called to the gospel ministry is that every now and then God allows us to ask you to use your imagination. So imagine with me that the center candle on the calabra is lit, or rather the two outside candles on the calabra is lit. With this in mind, the two outside candles of the center calabra has been lit to represent your life to this moment. They are two distinct lights, each capable of going their own separate ways to add bliss and happiness to your life and home. There must be the merging of these two lights into one. This is what the Lord meant when he said, on this account, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they too shall be one flesh. From now on, your thoughts shall be for each other rather than your individual selves. Your plans shall be mutual, your joys and sorrows shared alike. As you each would have taken a candle and lit the center one, you would have then extinguished your own candle, allowing the center candle to represent your union together in one flesh. As this one light cannot be divided, neither shall your lives be divided, but be a united testimony in a Christian home. May the radiance of this light that we now witness in our minds be a testimony of the unity in the Lord Jesus Christ.